Hi, I'm Brandon with Lenovo. Today I'm going to show you the best practices to use when you encounter a Lenovo system with LCD tape or command strips. As consumer demand for smaller, thinner, and more lightweight laptops increases, Lenovo has decided to replace the usual screws that attach LCD panels to the rear cover with tape or adhesive command strips. When a technician first encounters a system with this tape, the replacement process can seem a little unclear. I'm here to show you that the actual process is quite simple. Before we get started, there are no special tools required for the tape removal, but we do recommend using a good pair of tweezers, as this makes the process easier. If you're unaware whether or not a system you're working on has LCD tape, the easiest way to check is to look for small black tabs protruding out from under the LCD near the hinges on the bottom of the LCD panel or at the top of the panel. These tabs are here to give you access to the tape for removal. You'll want to take note of where these tabs are located because they will need to be arranged in the same way when you replace the tape. Another way to check if a system has LCD tape is to go to support.lenovo.com/parts-lookup and search the machine type model number. You can view the system schematic by going to the schematic submenu. In the exploded view diagram for LCD parts, you can see the option tape, which is labeled number 11. Now, if you click on 11, option tape, you can scroll down and look for a listing entitled Adhesive, Tape, Elastic, with a FRU part number. You can also click on the photos icon and see that this is the same LCD tape that we're going to be using later in this video. Let's replace some adhesive tape. Once you've located the tabs, you can use your fingers to pull the tape out a little bit to give yourself enough slack to begin wrapping it around a pair of tweezers. Once you've got some tape wrapped around the tweezers, you can pull the tape out a few inches and then gather the slack by rolling it up in the tweezers. You want to pull the tape out along the same axis as the LCD is sitting. Pulling the tape upwards or downwards slightly is okay, but the more exaggerated the angle, the more likely issues or breakage may occur. Pulling the tape out to the left or right side can also cause issues. You also want to assure that you're only pulling a few inches of tape out before collecting the slack in order to avoid stretching the surface area of the tape too thin. Then you're just going to repeat the process for any additional pieces of tape. Pull some tape out with your fingers, wrap it up in the tweezers, pull a few inches out, gather the slack, and repeat until the tape is removed. Now you can flip the LCD panel over, remove the tape that secures the LCD cable, disconnect the cable from the panel, and remove the panel from the system. I recommend connecting the LCD cable to the new panel and securing it with the tape before replacing the LCD tape. Once the panel is on there, you'll have to remove the tape all over again if you forgot to connect the cable. Now you're going to remove the LCD tape from the glossy white adhesive protector and put it into position on the LCD rear cover. You should be able to use the residue from the previous tape as a guideline, but if not, just make sure that the square tab that you use to access the tape will still be protruding from under the panel. Using your finger, press down on the tape to secure it to the rear cover. Once the tape is secured to the cover, you can remove the blue adhesive strip from the other side of the tape, pulling it up by the long excess strip. Then we're going to repeat the process with the next strip. Pulling it up from the glossy white adhesive protector, placing it into position on the rear cover, pressing down on the tape to secure it, and removing the blue strip by the excess strand. Now we can flip the panel over, carefully align it, and place it onto the adhesive. Now let's talk about what to do in the event that one or both pieces of tape breaks. If you break a piece of tape during the procedure, go immediately to the next piece or pieces and remove them. If you can successfully remove the other piece of tape, you'll probably be able to get your hand underneath the panel and very carefully and slowly open the panel like a book to about a 90 degree angle and free it from the broken piece of tape. Use your hand on the underside of the panel to ensure that it does not bend as you tilt the panel upward. Breaking both pieces of tape may require removing additional components. In the case of the system like the one shown in this video, the tape sits on top of the hinges. I would recommend removing the hinges with the LCD panel and then removing the hinges from the panel to lessen the likelihood of damaging it. This concludes the LCD tape best practices video. Following these guidelines, you should be ready to get out there and start replacing LCD tape without the fear of breaking the tape or damaging LCD panels.